YouTube, what's going on? Kyle again from ePoolSupply. Today we are back to talk to you guys about Pentair's temperature sensors. Stay tuned, we're going to dive in, kind of give you guys a little bit of an explanation and show you guys what to expect in the package. All right guys, and we're back. So again today we're going to go over Pentair's temperature sensors. So they actually don't have two different sensors based off of where you're going to use them for your equipment. So we're just going to kind of dive in here, show you guys what to expect from these sensors, and then kind of describe the differences on how you guys are going to actually wire them up based off of your use. So Pentair gives you the opportunity, like I said, it's one sensor to accomplish two things. So you have a temperature sensor for your water, as well as a temperature sensor for the air. So they are the exact same sensors, and they can be used the exact same way. One just gets plumbed into your actual plumbing, and another will actually just hang out and kind of dangle from your automation system, whatever it may be there that's gonna give you that temperature reading for outside temperature, but they are exactly the same. So even when you guys have this just dangling, it's gonna still have the same white probe just dangling off of your automation system on your equipment. I always suggest that if you're gonna do the air sensor one, make sure that you guys cut this cord down to like a little bit that's actually showing outside of the your automation system, because you don't want the opportunity for any birds or rats to chew on the wires. So I always suggest either tucking everything extra back into your automation system or just cutting the wire to be short enough for you guys to work the way that you need it to. So it's the actual temperature end, and then the other side is just exposed red and white wires. So obviously if you cut it back, you're gonna need to strip the actual outside of the wire back just enough to be able to get a direct contact to the internal wires, which they already do for you guys, but they do plug into the automation system exactly the same. It's just about what you guys have them doing. So if you're having a water temperature set, you actually need to drill in through your PVC pipe. This will actually slide down into the hole that you drill into your pipe, and then you're going to take a hose clamp that goes around, and then you guys got to make sure that you guys kind of really glue this in, because it needs to obviously hold, it needs to hold into the pipe. You can't have any leaks. So there's no O-rings or pieces, so that when you guys actually do put these in, it needs to make sure that it seals. They do have a little O-ring right here on the bottom, I apologize, so that as you push it down, you guys just want to make sure you get plenty of glue on that so that everything actually seals for you and that you don't take the risk of water leaking from your sensor. So this will give you reading temperatures on your water running through, whether that be if you've got your pump running the whole time, so it can be whether or not it's just the water that's sitting in your system, or if you have your pump running, it'll be the actual temperatures of your pool. So it's really nice to be able to kind of see what your water temperatures are like. And then obviously, again, if you leave this just hanging outside, you're going to be looking at air sensors. So then that way you can just kind of tell you guys outside temperatures in perspective to your water. So then that way you guys can just decide whether or not you need to keep the heater on, or whether or not you're going to go swimming that day, or whatever it may be. So pretty straightforward. They're going to give you the little user manual in here for you guys, so you guys can dive in. It'll show you guys all the different installation tips on how to do that, making sure that you actually drill in properly. It'll tell you the drill bit that you guys need. It's a 3/8 drill bit, as well as showing you guys how to just make sure you wire them in correctly to the actual automation system to give you those readings. So pretty straightforward, but I did just want to let you guys know that it is the exact same sensor for both water and air. So when you're looking at this, you're not looking for one or the other. It is just the one sensor. You're looking at part number 520272. We've got links in the description for these directly on our website, all genuine OEM Pentair products. So make sure you guys hit that like button. Be sure to subscribe. We got a ton of videos coming your way, maybe even an installation of one of these out in the field. So until then, Kyle from ePoolSupply. We'll see you next time.